I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help.
We're back in the office of Mayor Bob Zavia here in Ponchatoula. I always say if these cypress-laden walls could talk, what a story they would tell. But the story these days is economic development. I've lost track of the new businesses here, and there are more coming. Could be a lot worse.
Ken, that's true. As a matter of fact, just before our appointment here, I did a ribbon cutting downtown. We have one more scheduled for the end of the week, and then I've been told by the director that we have 14 more coming. So things are really good down here. We've got a lot of new businesses downtown. You know, since the Janneking building became vacant and they moved to their great facility out west of town, they're making that office suites in there. And for the most part, I think probably 80 or 90% are occupied. So we're very happy about that. We've got going down LA 22 East. We've got our sidewalk project that's probably 80% complete. They started in the worst of the weather time of the year in November. And of course, you know what's happened the last couple of weeks. But they're finishing up on that project for us. We're waiting, anticipating the testing of the interstate lights here in the next couple of weeks. We'll be notifying, putting out a press release when we get that, because it's probably going to be on phases, in phases, and some of the lights will be on, some of them will be off for about a week or so while they're doing testing. Ken, we have in our industrial park another project going on down there with Reagan and Massey is doing an expansion of about 100,000 feet of warehouse space. Ken, you're right. Things look really good here.
More restaurants coming?
Ken, we've had a few new ones opened. Tula Burger downtown has done really well. They're new downtown. Joe's Italian restaurant out on 51 has done well. And all of our locals that are here, Ruin Brew, Paulo's, Paul's, we're good. Come down and dine in Ponchatoula.
What I did is, it turns out, about a week ago on a Saturday night, and the place was jamming. Never thought it would be like that in Ponchatoula, except at Strawberry Festival time.
Ken, that's right. I've seen a lot of activity. You come through here some Friday nights and some Saturday nights. The main street is packed. In front of the railroad tracks, both sides of Pine Street are full of parking, and there are people milling around. And we're very pleased with that. And I think we're working, with our downtown revitalization director. She has been, promoting existing businesses as well as new ones, and we're getting ready to have an initiative there again. But progress has shown all the way around. Sales tax have proven that things are happening here. Our sales tax are well over our projections at this point, waiting on the latest report today or tomorrow. And
but up double digits.
Oh, it is, absolutely. We've done well. Can't really explain it. I don't know whether the stimulus money had something to do with it or not. But from July to where we are today, we're substantially ahead.
What do you make, being married, of course, to an accomplished artist, about the explosion in the amount of art in Ponchatoula? I've lost track of the art galleries you have here. Who would have ever thought that people will speak of the Ponchatoula Arts District?
Well, kid, we're very blessed. We've had some new, the Siakinins have just opened their gallery. Mandy has opened a gallery downtown. And of course, the big thing that we're really excited about, private venture, but the Twin Steeples project that is being put together by Harry Gabriel and his board. I know they met last night. The churches have been turned around. I think the structural work within the churches are going to start soon. The groundwork and some of that outside construction will get started as well. So, yes, talk about an art community, we're there.
And what kind of events would you expect to be there at the Twin Steeples project?
Well, Ken, they're going to be performing arts, I think. We're going to see a lot of that, a lot of talent. We have a lot of talent in Ponchatoula in areas. One of the people on the board is James Square, who was the band director out at Ponchatoula High School for years and years. And he has some tremendous ideas for performers, musicians. And so there's just going to be a variety of things. I haven't seen Kim is on the board and working with that project and is in constant contact with Harry. And I think that by the end of the summer, we'll have something really special here.
So the image that you're getting of the new Punchatoula is going to be an art city with lots of vibrant nightlife, great restaurants, lots of the performing arts. This is not Mayberry. I mean, this is not a sleepy little town where nothing ever happens and they roll the sidewalks up at dark. I mean, this is somewhat the opposite of what you would have expected.
Again, you know, people, some of our residents have worked very hard, and our business people have worked very hard to be where we are. You know, I think that the restaurants are first class that we have downtown and in town. I just don't want to say downtown. You know, the entertainment is getting even better. As you said, the cultural aspect is very rewarding to be a part of.
And I want to say, too, that if you, and again, I want to give credit to your lovely wife, but if you're looking for art, Punchatoula, I mean, you've got some great art galleries here.
Ken, that's true. And an odd thing about the pandemic, you know, this has probably been one of Kim's best years. And I think that the other artists will say the same, because I think a lot of it was online buying. But there was, you know, a lot of walking out of the stores downtown. The Revival is doing quite well. Siakin is right next to him. And come on up to the Escape Warehouse, and then you hit the dining district of the Ruin Brew. So we're happy.
Now, at those art houses that you're describing, I have met people from a very wide area. I mean, I'm talking about Alabama to Texas, that come to Punchatoula to buy art. That's incredible. You would, 5 years ago, have never believed that.
Ken, that's true, but there's been a lot of work done in a period of time to get to that stage. And, you know, as the art galleries and the art products begin to show up in the galleries in the streets, people will come. You know, we're proud of that.
So you have to actually think about the fact that one way or another, the pandemic, let's hope, is almost behind us. Boy, Katie barred the door when you get to the second half of this year.
Ken, we are, you know, that we're very glad to hear the governor say move us into phase three. And he cautioned, and I do as well, you know, let's don't let our guard down. We've come this far. Let's ride it out to the end and be safe. But yeah, we're looking for some exciting things coming in the summer and in the fall. I think some of the events that were canceled earlier this year are reformulating something on a scale down basis. Certainly we'll see trade days again in November, wide open. I think this weekend, a lot of the merchants downtown are going to be outside and have sales going on. So we invite everybody to come shop downtown Punchatoula. It's supposed to be a great weekend, according to the weatherman. So,
you know, I was thinking about you guys when the governor was speaking on his last live broadcast, and he said, remember, you're always safer outdoors than indoors. And I'm thinking, well, sounds like a good entree to the weekend in Punchatoula coming up.
Well, Ken, you know, there was a lot of discussion about the Strawberry Festival and about Antique Trade Days. But, you know, we just decided to be on the safe side. We were still in phase two when those decisions were made. But I think that we are going to see a lot of outside activities. You know, I prefer to be outside anyway. But I think Punchatoula this weekend will be good, and weekends coming will be as well. And I ask people to just kind of stay in touch to see what events are going to be rescheduled later in the year. Won't be to the same caliber, to the same extent that, you know, the regular would be. But I know that the Strawberry Festival Board is thinking about, you know, maybe a reduced farmers auction, strawberry auction, and a couple of things for the civic organization. But I will tell you that I know they're planning wide open for next year's Strawberry Festival.
You know, it's interesting that I see not only is our hospitality industry in the broad sense in Tangipahoa Parish intact, boy, it's better than ever. I mean, look at the hotels, look at the restaurants, look at the entertainment venues, more coming. I mean, I've said this and it sounds like hyperbole, but there's no place else in America I would rather be coming out of this pandemic.
I'm with you, Ken. I'm telling you. And look at Southeastern football and baseball, and look at the PHS girls basketball game coming up tonight. at Southeastern. So we're excited on all tourism. You know, sports brings people. They shop at the shops. They stay at our motels. They eat at our restaurants. And a lot of them come to Ponchatoula.
What else are you working on?
Ken, we're working. As a matter of fact, I have a meeting in Covington at 1:30 today. We're working on our downtown pedestrian project. It's taken quite some time, but we have our engineers involved, our planners, and actually have two representatives from DOTD that's going to attend the meeting. And we're trying to coordinate a lot of events that are going to happen or a lot of activities that's going to happen regarding improvements downtown, improvements that affects the state right-of-way, improvements that affect our city sidewalks and pedestrian crossings. So it's a long, long project. We've probably got 4 years on it now. Hopefully within the next 2 years, we'll be able to see some real bricks and mortar down there.
To make Ponchatoula easier to just walk around?
Right. It's a pedestrian project, basically crossings, signals, if we can get that. We've learned that that's extremely expensive because there's a lot of studies that have to go on before we get the go-ahead to do that. But landscaping, handicap accessibility, trying to slow the traffic down just a little bit in town. But other than that, again, it's a grand project. Our consolidated board is seeing the preliminary plans, but we are developing every day as we go and jumping through the hoops that we have to with the federal and state agencies to get our approval.
And your downtown district idea, that's moving forward. Any bill coming up in the legislature for that?
Ken, no. We're still examining as to whether we think that's a good fit for us or not. Our board, as we're doing now, or as our downtown revitalization director, is accomplishing just about everything we could have accomplished with the DDD, with the exception of being able to form a taxing district. So, you know, with the economy the way that it is now and what we're seeing downtown, I think we're in the right direction.
It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangylawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.